really doesn't matter who you are or where you're from, if you're a guy or girl, young or old. When it comes to Jeepers, there's a common bond that we all share. A love for the outdoors, a desire to explore, a yearning to take on a challenge, and a will to conquer it. And I suppose it's because of this bond that you can have a total stranger contact you out of the blue, as if you were old friends, and ask if you would be willing to lead some Kunniks through the Rubicon Trail. At least, that's what happened a little over 6 months ago, and why we're here today. Tell us the whole story about how you got here.
It was a year ago. Me and these two knuckleheads here were talking about just like epic road trips that we could do with our Jeep.
And then nobody really came up with anything to do.
Yeah.
And that's when I PM'd you and I'm like, well, we want to do the Rubicon on these days. You said, well, come out one day early, we can do it.
Even though it's the middle of August, with daytime temps expected to be in the upper 80s, the early morning drive from Tahoe down to the start of the Rubicon Trail is typically one that most prefer to do with a heavy jacket, and if you've got it, heated seats. Down at the Loon Lake staging area, we met up with our good friends David and Mike, who, in spite of having very little notice, were eager to come out and help tail gun for our group. Climbing out of the granite bowl, there are a set of ledges that can be a real challenge to climb, especially if you're in a two-door. And, as Grant would soon discover, it can be tough enough to bite you if you're not being careful.
I just fell off the rock.
Can you tell me what you'd find? I'll tell you if you keep it.
Just as we were about to head out, Bill let us know that he found what looked like fresh bits of metal lying on the ground, and after giving all our Jeeps a thorough once over, this is what we found.
He's got a crack in his U-joint cap.
We got almost every single spare part you can replace with fuel pumps, water pumps.
I don't have the fuel pump.
Oh, you didn't bring it? Okay, screw you. Radiator hose. Upper and lower ball joints,
leaking brake,
you know, everything, MRE, just in case you got to stay extra, you know, nights, and what else we got? So thermostat and everything else.
I think we have a steering
ball. Anybody need a oil change?
And we're going up the hill and nothing happened, but then he went away and I turned.
Yeah.
As soon as I turned, this is when the clicking sound comes.
Out on the trail, any tool you can use is the right one for the job, so long as it gets the job done. I can't control it. Channels have chosen what I'm supposed to be. Murphy's Law would dictate that anything that can go wrong, will go wrong. And for us, that would mean making a stupid mistake of installing a Dana 30 U-joint on a 44 shaft.
I drove all the way from Canada to hit Rubicon. Hey, it was a 2-day long trip for us. And when we got here, just at the trailhead, I break my front.
We all know that we can do
you
that
joined.
In 2 days.
I was really looking forward to this trail, and we were talking about this trail for the last 8 months. How we're gonna make this trip, and we all booked a vacation, and it's really unfortunate that I broke down right at the trailhead.
For better or for worse, I'm always amazed at the places where you can actually get a cell phone signal. While it wasn't the best, it was just enough to make a few important calls and come up with a game plan. With half of our group staying behind to set up camp, the rest of us would head back to town and get Sammy fixed up. And, with the help of a friend nearby, we were able to do just that and get us back to the start of the Rubicon before sundown. Take two. What would a trip to the Rubicon be without at least giving the little sluice a good, hard, and tempting look? Remember that thing I was saying about Murphy's Law?
So I go, Tim, big favor, let me just borrow your spare. I probably won't have to run it. Everything will be fine. You know, like, just loan me your spare. It'll be cool.
Right there. Yay.
You punctured your spare.
Oh my God. The glass.
It's from the kangaroo bag. There's
something
a bottle inside
in the bag
and went,
oh no.
After seeing all the partying these guys did the night before, I have to say that I'm a little surprised to see any of them up and about this early in the morning. But then, they're Canadians. Four days ago, seven guys from Canada drove 1,000 miles to meet us in South Lake Tahoe and with the hopes of running one of the most famous hardcore trails in America, the Rubicon Trail. At the time, none of us had ever met each other, seen each other, or even spoken to each other by phone before, and yet none of us actually saw ourselves as being strangers. After all, we were Jeepers. And a funny thing happens after a group of Jeepers get together and conquer a trail like the Rubicon. They become family. Until next time, keep the shiny side up, all four on the floor, and with any luck, we'll see you on the trail.
Okay, tell us about the mud story. When did it happen, and okay, what did they do?
Okay, this is how it started. You guys were all up to the bypass on the right, and Sam was in front of me, and I knew he was thinking about the mud.
Right,
and
we all
he
were.
He knew that I was thinking about the mud. So all I did was, I pulled off to the right a hair, I looked back at Stevie, and I was like, we doing this? And he's like, yeah.